About pharmacists and health IT. And as Lauren said, I'm the executive director of the pharmacy, what we call HIT. And we're also calling it FIT, PHIT, because we have to shorten our name. But we leave pharmacy in place there so that others within the healthcare industry really know who we represent. So basically, we're going to talk about a couple of things about what is health informatics, and really the pharmacist's relationship to health informatics as it is sort of in the eyes of the pharmacy HIT collaborative. If we look at informatics, what is informatics? It's really the study of data. It's more of what you would learn in school or at junior universities where you are now. So we have many types of definitions in relationship to informatics. If you look at health informatics, you're really looking at an interdisciplinary study, you know, all the different disciplines within healthcare for healthcare services. But if we look at the study of health information, it really is important to, as we get into further definitions as it relates to patients. So what is clinical informatics? Now, these are all terms that are being used today, which is really more related to the setting or the practice setting. And medical informatics goes back into that interdisciplinary study or interprofessional study in terms of health services. And I know this is the question you're all interested in. What is pharmacy informatics? Pharmacy informatics sort of focuses on the medication-related data. So basically, if you take informatics and you talk about health or clinical or medical or pharmacy, it's really information and how that information relates to patients, because we're all here to take care of our patients. Talk a little bit about the Pharmacy HIT Collaborative. And I'm so honored to actually be able to represent pharmacists on behalf of the profession. In 2010, 9 of the pharmacy professional associations came together to form the Pharmacy HIT Collaborative. It represents over 250,000 members throughout the United States in all different practice settings. And as you heard earlier, we have an alphabet soup of these organizations, but it is all of the American Pharmacists Association. The association represents the colleges of pharmacy, even the association that credits the colleges of pharmacy and even pharmacists for continuing education, the National Alliance of State Pharmacy Association. So we get down to that state level representation, managed care, long-term post-acute care, hospital, all of the different areas, even community pharmacy. We opened the collaborative to associate members because we're a very open collaborative. We want to make sure the work that we're doing is reflected on many different levels. And so these other organizations, SureScripts, the National Council for Prescription Drug Programs, Relay Health, Outcomes MTM, Amgen, Pfizer, and Cardinal Health Hughes are associate members of the collaborative, and they participate in the work we're doing. They are not a voting member. Only a professional association could be a voting member of the collaborative, so we maintain the direction of the profession in relationship to health IT. Our mission and vision is basically this: pharmacists that provide patient care services and how those services are integrated into the national health IT infrastructure. So I really don't focus on the dispensing portion or the billing portion in relationship to the actual product, but focus on those pharmacists that provide patient care services. Don't get me wrong, we're very concerned about the dispensing portion, but it is as it relates to those professional services. So you heard earlier in my bio as we talked about our goals. And our goals for the collaborative is in relationship to access, connectivity, and quality. How do we as pharmacists access the information that we need to meet informatics? How do we connect that information with others? And then how do we really measure from a quality standpoint, the work that we're doing, is it actually fitting the quality needs of the patients that we serve? A huge amount of information on our website. This information, I encourage you to go. It's www.pharmacyhit.org. We have a great deal of information there. Several different areas, resources. We also provide comments back to HHS, Health and Human Services, Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services, and the Office of the National Coordinator on requests for information related to health IT and how us as pharmacists provide patient care, those pharmacists that provide patient care services, how they actually work within this process. I don't know if I'm doing something. This is one of our first documents that we put out, which was really an environmental scan of where we are within pharmacy and where we are within pharmacists that provide these patient care services. It has 10 goals and over 100 different strategies where we need to fit into this whole aspect of our national health IT infrastructure. We also have a section for strategic plans, of which really take our goals and our mission and vision and then show how we can actually relate to that first document that we put out on those 10 goals. Recently in 2014, that takes us all the way through 2017, we created an update of that document where we looked at the goals that were specific to the Pharmacy HIT Collaborative. We do quite a bit of work throughout the United States in relationship to this. We have four work groups that work on different areas in relationship to billing for professional services. We're actually the stewards and have representation on the American Medical Association's current procedure terminology, what they call CPT codes, or their panel. And so we relate to some of the billing documentation for professional services like our MTM, Medication Therapy Management Services billing. Work on documentation codes that we'll use to clinically document information, workflow, health information exchanges. We have over 100 volunteers who work on this who are appointed by the members of the collaborative. We do every now and then get some students to help us, so you have to be appointed through your professional association, so I encourage you to get involved with your professional associations. We also have work with the standards development organizations, and here in the United States, there's three of them. There's Health Level 7 and NCPDP, the National Council for Prescription Drug Programs, which oversees the pharmacy standards, and X12, which does a lot of the billing standards for medical billing. This is how I got involved into the level of understanding. When I was a pharmacist, I just questioned how systems were working. If I didn't like it, I worked with my vendor to get it changed. And then as I moved on, I began to look at the standards of how we were actually developing these standards. All of these organizations have virtual task groups. And I put the links on this, but we'll be sending the links out to you on these slides, but you can go in and listen to calls, be involved, get involved in standards work, so you really begin to learn how pharmacy fits into the overall health IT infrastructure in the United States. Some of these organizations, like HL7, is international, so if you have an international flair, you can certainly get involved. We also do work with the state health information exchanges to help support some of our state association activities. And we're working on a new area called electronic structured documents. So I'm sure that all of you have heard about electronic prescribing, which is really just taking that electronic prescription, and then that electronic prescription actually then becomes a form, in an electronic form that gets shared. Well, this is the same type of concept we're doing with other types of documents, like a discharge summary or a patient care summary, or a continuity of care document, walking into the doctor's office and filling out that clipboard of information. That's your continuity of care document. So these are documents that we started to work on in conjunction. We harmonize between the two standards development organizations, HL7 and NCPDP. And we create this new document, these new forms, electronic forms that are standardized for exchange, so we could share the information with patients, with other healthcare providers, and even with payers. Because we move into this new area of exchanging information and the role of pharmacists, a more clinical role, we're able to exchange that information. Within our website, we have several documents. We call them guidance documents that we've produced. These are some of our documents from our website that deal with some of the billing codes and the CPT codes to really help you begin to understand how this is used and where pharmacists fit into that overall structure. Because if we're going to be successful in taking care of our patients, we have to work in a team with everyone else, including the patients themselves. This group of documents is really focused on some of the standards development work and codifying so that we can collect information within our systems and begin to document that information and then share it with others. And so these documents are focused on coding. We have terms, SNOMED CT codes. This is a set of terminology that is an international terminology, but in the United States, it's been geared as the terminology that will be used for certified health IT systems. This is really important work, and the work that we've tried to do in these documents is really to help our pharmacists understand how to enable health IT to really do the work that you need to do. Not that it should be driving you in how to document, but you should be able to document clinically your interventions and your encounters with your patients and begin to let the system capture that information in a standard way so it can be shared in an interoperable way. We've also worked on some work for pharmacogenomics to get a base, because this is the wave of the future of where we're going for the future. The Joint Commission of Pharmacy Practitioners, which is really where the Pharmacy HIT Collaborative falls out of, we're part of their strategic initiative for health IT. Those nine professional organizations sort of make up the JCPP organization. They came out with the pharmacist patient care process. Now, the schools of pharmacy are beginning to use this within their curriculum, so we can document how the pharmacist begins to document their work. This is really important because, you know, when you go into the doctor's office, what happens? They begin, you take your vital signs, you get your temperature taken, your weight, which isn't always nice to do, but they do that, and your blood pressure. And then you go and you sit and you see the doctor, and then the doctor does the assessment, and then they lead to a diagnosis. These are processes of care that each healthcare profession does. Well, this is the process of care that we're doing as pharmacists. Now, some of you might have heard the pharmaceutical care model. This is sort of the updated version of the pharmaceutical care model. And so it's going to be really important that you begin to think about that in terms of how you interact with your patient encounter and how it fits into this process. What we do on the health IT side is we look at that process, and these little bubbles that are out really show you the points that where information comes in and goes out of your system. Because you have to be able to document within your system in a very productive way. So information has to come out, and information has to go out in a way that it can be shared. So the last thing we want you to do is stop your workflow, go log into another system, and then you've sort of lost your whole train of thought. But look at this analogy. I know all of you use emails. So if I send you an email, you can open it up, you can read it. I might have a Gmail, you might have Outlook, but the two of us can share information. Could you imagine a system where I had to call you up on the phone or send you a text? By the way, I sent you an email. Okay, you stop what you're doing, you go to another system, you download it, you print it off, and you retype it into your system so you can send me a message back. And this is what we expect of our healthcare systems today. We need to have a system that's interoperable and exchangeable, as easy it is for you to exchange an email. This is the document that this group works on, workflow. and follows that patient care process. So these documents were really meant for pharmacists who do provide patient care services to really understand how they can talk to their system vendors to make sure their system vendors are programming to that workflow. Our last group works on certification of our health IT systems to make sure that the systems can talk to each other. There are certain rules and regulations in place. Just like you're sending a pharmacy claim today, your system vendors go through a certification process to make sure that they understand that information. You do that with an email today, but it's seamless to you. But there are certain protocols that you have set up to make sure that your system understands the internet and vice versa. In terms of the certification process and in terms of the standards development work, we work very closely with the standards development organizations, HL7 and NCPDP, to harmonize the standards so we don't duplicate them. This is really important because we do work within the National Council for Prescription Drug Programs, but there's a lot of work that's taking place in terms of patient care services that are taking place at HL7. These are two examples of documents that we've worked on that harmonization, and more are coming. So this brings us back to access, connectivity, and quality. As pharmacists, how do we access the information that we need in a seamless way, as seamless as it is for an email that you're receiving? You should be able to receive that in your own system. You should be able to utilize that information like laboratory information or diagnosis information or discharge information. You should have all of that information available. You should be able to walk through your steps of observation and assessment with that patient, identify your interventions, notice the outcomes that have taken place, whether you've made a recommendation to change a dose or to discontinue a medication or to add a medication, and then to set up goals with that patient so they understand how important it is for them that the medications that they're taking are important. So how do we connect that information that you've just obtained, all that very rich clinical information, with somebody else? How do you make that connection? How do we enable technology to actually make that connection? And then the last piece is quality. Once you've gotten this rich clinical data identified in a very standard, codified way, we can now do measures on that information. Here in the United States, we use claims information, the dispensing information, to measure adherence or other aspects of care. This is where we really need to now have this rich information. It's going to be up to all of you to make that determination of how you interact with your patient. So it isn't just about dispensing the medication. It's about what impact you've had on that patient to assure that they've optimized their medications. And we need that information to get the quality portions of what we're looking for.